Hello everyone, welcome back to another technical session on sway frames. So in my earlier video I have solved a problem related to sway frame where the loading was asymmetrical. In this frame our columns of the frame are asymmetrical, correct? Means you observe the column AB is of height 3 meters and the column CD is of 4 meters. Like the both the columns are, I mean the heights of the columns are different, or else the both the supports are not at the same place, I mean at the same heights. So this is column asymmetrical condition. So this will be a case of sway frame as I've told earlier. Okay, now let's analyze this frame. So what is the first step in our slope deflection method? Well, our first step will be writing the fixed end moments. So I've started writing the fixed end moments. So m bar ab is 0. Why? Because there is no load acting on AB. Next, m bar ba is also 0. Next, m bar bc is, since this is a UDL, it will be minus WL square by 12. So minus 20 into 5 square by 12, which is minus 41.67 kilonewton meter. Similarly, m bar cb is 20 into 5 square by 12, which is 41.67. m bar cd is 0. Why? Because there is no load on cd. Similarly, m bar dc also will be 0. So this is how we write the first step, which is writing the fixed end moments. Now let's go for step 2, which is writing the slope deflection equations. Okay, so we have 6 end moments, so we will get 6 slope deflection equations. Now let's start off with MAB. MAB is equals to m bar AB plus 2 EI by L into 2 theta A plus theta B minus 3 delta by L. This is the formula, correct? Now as I've told you already in my earlier video, when there is a sway, it means that the columns are subjected to relative displacement, not the beam. So hence when you are writing for columns, you need to put this delta value. Okay, columns are swaying, so delta value will exist when you are doing for columns, and delta will be 0 when you are doing for the beam. Why? Because even though the sway happens, the beam dimension or the beam will not sway, the columns will sway. Okay, so when you are doing for columns, when you're writing slope deflection equations for the columns, you have to involve delta also. So first, coming to MAB, as I've told you, the equation m bar AB is already 0 from step 1 plus 2 into E into I is I itself by span of AB is 3 by 3 into theta A is 0. Why? Because end A is fixed. So into theta B minus 3 delta by L is what again? 3, same L. So finally, I got MAB as 2 EI by 3 theta B minus 2 EI delta by 3. So I'll take this as equation number 1. Similarly, let's do for MBA. What's the formula of MBA? M bar BA plus 2 EI by L into 2 theta B plus theta A minus 3 delta by L. Okay, as I've told you, here BA, B is coming first, so it will be 2 times theta B. A, so plus theta A. So again, theta A became 0. M bar BA is also 0. So MBA is equal to 2 EI by 3 into 2 theta B minus 3 delta by 3. So finally MBA will be equal to 4 EI by 3 theta B minus 2 EI by 3 delta. Okay, take this as equation number 2. Let's continue with writing the slope deflection equations. Next comes MBC. The formula is m bar BC plus 2 EI by L into 2 theta B plus theta C minus 3 delta by L. So BC is the beam part, right? In the frame, the horizontal part. So there you need not put delta. So delta will become 0. Theta B and theta C will exist. Why? Because both of them are not fixed. So MBC is equal to m bar BC we got from step 1 as minus 41.67 plus 2E into I was given as 1.5I. If you remember the question, I was 1.5I and the span was 5. So 2E into 1.5 into I by 5 into 2 theta B plus theta C. To simplify the equation, you will be ending up with MBC is equal to minus 41.67 plus, this is 3. 2 into 1.5 will become 3. So 3 into 2 is 6. 6 by 5 EI theta B plus 3 by 5 EI theta C. That's equation number 3. Similarly, MCB. MCB is m bar CB plus 2 EI by L into 2 theta C plus theta B minus 3 delta by L. Again, MCB is 41.67 plus 2E into 1.5I by 5 into 2 theta C plus theta B. As usual, delta is 0 here. So finally, MCB becomes 41.67 plus 6 by 5 EI theta C plus 3 by 5 EI theta B. That will be our equation number 4. So till here we are done with writing 4 slope deflection equations with respect to 4 fixed end moments. Next one will be MCD. For the column CD part, M bar CD plus 2 EI by L into 2 theta C plus theta D minus 3 delta by L. Here D is fixed, so only theta D will be 0. Since CD is the column, you have to consider this way, which is delta. So MCD is equal to, since they did not give us the value of delta, we should consider it as delta itself. Suppose if they give some value, 1 mm or 2 mm, something like that, you could have added substituted here, but it's not given, so let delta be like delta only. So M bar CD is 0 plus 2 EI by 4 into 4 is what, span of CD, into 2 theta C, this became 0, minus 3 delta by 4. Finally, I'll end up MCD as EI theta C minus 3 by 8 EI delta. Just simplify this, multiply and simplify, you'll be getting this equation. That will be equation number 5. Let's continue with MDC. MDC is M bar DC plus 2 EI by L into 2 theta D plus theta C minus 3 delta by L. As usual, only theta D will be 0 here. Okay, why? Why? Because D is fixed. This we have already written here. So theta D will be 0. So other than that, M bar DC is already 0. Why? Because there was no load acting. Plus 2 EI by 4 into theta C minus 3 delta by 4. Finally, our MDC will be EI by 2 theta C minus 3 by 8 EI delta. That will be our equation number 6. So here we end up writing all the 6 slope deflection equations. We have 6 fixed end moments. Hence, we will be getting 6 slope deflection equations. So till here we are completed. Next will be our step number 3. What is our step number 3 about? Writing the equilibrium conditions. So according to our problem, we have 2 joints. One is B and one is C. So first equilibrium condition will be at joint B. So what will be the condition? MBA. That is the moment which is moving towards left of B, MBA, and the moment which is moving towards right of B, which is MBC, should be equal to 0. Summation of them should be equal to 0. So the first equilibrium condition will be MBA plus MBC equal to 0. Similarly, the second equilibrium condition will be at C, joint C. So again, the moment which is going towards left of C, which is MCB, and the moment which is going towards the right of C, MCD. Again, addition of them should be equal to 0. So at C, so at joint C, MCB plus MCD is equal to 0. That will be our second equilibrium condition. And since we are solving for sway now, as I told you, for sway, we have to take sigma h is equal to 0. We will apply a horizontal equilibrium condition, sigma h is equal to 0. Summation of all horizontal forces acting on the frame will be equal to 0. So we have here, from A we have one horizontal reaction HA, from D we have one horizontal reaction HD. That's all, we don't have any externally applied horizontal forces. So HA plus HD equal to 0. This will be our third equilibrium condition. Clear? First two, that is at joint B and at joint C, whatever we are applying are called joint conditions or joint equilibrium conditions. Whereas what we write, HA plus HD is equal to 0. That is, so that's HA plus HD equal to 0 or sigma H equal to 0 will be our third equilibrium condition. So now let's start off applying the equilibrium conditions. Yeah, let's come back. So as I've told you, at joint B, MBA plus MBC equal to 0. So your MBA and MBC, what we got from our second step. So I have MBA here, 4 EI by 3 theta B minus 2 EI by 3 delta plus MBC. I have here minus 41.67 plus 6 by 5 EI theta B plus 3 by 5 EI theta C. Just add both of them. I've added and equate to 0 and just simplify. Here I have 4 by 3 EI theta B. Here I have 6 by 5 EI theta B. I've just took the LCM. I got 38 by 15 EI theta B plus 3 by 5 EI theta C minus 2 EI delta by 3 minus 41.67 equal to 0. That will be our equation number 7. The first equilibrium condition after you apply, whatever simplifying you get the equation, that will be taken as equation number 7. Next, let's apply the joint condition at C. As I've told you, MCB plus MCD equal to 0. MCB is already from your equation number 4. this value 41.67 plus 6 by 5 EI theta C plus 3 by 5 EI theta B plus MCD is your equation number 5, which is EI theta C minus 3 by 8 EI delta. So just add both of them and just simplify. You'll end up with 3 by 5 EI theta B plus 11 by 5 EI theta C minus 3 EI delta by 8 plus 41.67 equal to 0. That's our equation number 8. So equation 7 and equation 8 came from joint equilibrium conditions, which we applied at B and C respectively. Now let's apply the third equilibrium condition. What is that? Sigma H is equal to 0. Okay. As I've told you, the third equilibrium condition will be sigma H is equal to 0. Or you can, some people write it as sigma fx equal to 0. So what are our two horizontal forces on the frame? We have only H and HD, as already told you. There is no externally applied horizontal force on the frame. You have only H and HD. How this came? Why? Because A and D are fixed. At a fixed support, you have a horizontal reaction. So that was from H and HD. So finally, summation of H must be equal to 0 means HA plus HD equal to 0. So I am drawing the free body diagram of the columns, okay, which is AB and which is CD. I have just drawn the FBDs of two columns only, okay, because I need the values of H and HD. Now, see this diagram, first diagram. So this is the free body diagram of column AB. So here I have HA and here I have RA, okay. Next, I am assuming HA is moving towards right side, okay. As I've told you, we assume both MAB and MBA to be in clock directions only. Okay, so MAB is in clock direction and MBA is also in clock direction. Clear? Now, if I take moments about B, I will get the value of HA. So, I will take moments at B. So, taking moments about B, see how HA is going towards B? Anti-clock direction. So, minus HA into span of AB is 3. Minus HA into 3 plus MAB is going in clock plus MAB. MBA is also acting clock direction at B, so plus MBA is equal to 0. So from here, if I simplify, I get HA as MAB plus MBA by 3. Okay, this is HA value, keep it aside. Similarly, consider the free body diagram of the column CD alone. Now, I have at D, D is a fixed support, right? So at D, I have RD and I have HD. I am assuming HD to act towards, I mean from left, from right to left. Okay, I'm assuming this reverse direction. Why? Because HA is already acting like this, no? So I'm thinking HD to act like this, which is from right to left. Okay, now since I'm, now just listen carefully. When I took HA, HA was from which to which direction? Left to right. When HA was from left to right, I assumed both the moments to be clock. Now HD is from right to left. So, I should assume both the moments to be anti-clock. So, MCD is anti-clock, MDC is also anti-clock. Now, taking moments about C in order to get HD. So, take moments about C. How HD will act? HD will go like this, which is clock. So, HD into 4 minus MDC minus MCD. Both are anti-clock, equal to 0. If I simplify, I get HD as MCD plus MDC by 4. Keep this aside. So, I am ready with HA and HD. Once I get the values of MAB, MBA, MCD and MDC, I will substitute here and I will get the reactions, horizontal reactions, okay? So, what was our equilibrium condition I told you? Third condition, HA plus HD equal to 0, right? So, HA I got from here, put it here. HD I got from here, put it here. Just equate to 0. And just simplify here. Take a LCM, it will be 12. So, it will be 4 times MAB plus MBA. Plus 3 times MCD plus MDC. This 12 will go that side, which becomes 0. Just open MAB value, MBA value, MCD, MDC. We got from our slope deflection equation step. Right? Which we denoted with equation 1, equation 2, equation 5 and equation 6. Just substitute all the values here. Okay? If you remember this point. These equations, what we got? MDC, MCD, MAB, MBA, these, okay, just substitute them, okay, just a minute, yeah, so just substitute and open the brackets and start simplifying and finally you will end up with 8 ei theta b plus 4.5 ei theta c minus 7.58 ei delta is equal to 0. This is where you will stop. Okay, that will be taken as equation number 9. Clear? HA you calculate, HD you calculate, substitute in the places of MA, MAB, MBA, MCD, MDC from slope deflection equations. You just substitute the values, simplify them, open the brackets, do all the possible addition, subtraction, and take LCMs, whatever. Finally, you'll end up with this equation number 9. So I have equations 7, 8, and 9, which are the three equilibrium conditions. And I have three unknowns, which is EI theta B, EI theta C, or rather theta B, theta C, and delta. Three unknowns are there, three equations are there. So I can solve, right? So now our next step will be directly solve equations 7, 8, and 9. What was our equation 7? Which was the equilibrium equation applied and simplified at joint B. 8 was, which was the equilibrium equation applied and simplified at joint C. Equation 9 was equilibrium condition, which is sigma H equal to 0. So finally solve these three equations, take a calc, go to your mode setup, take a equation setup and start putting the values. You will end up with getting the values of EI theta B, EI theta C and EI delta like this. So finally I got EI theta B as minus 25.41. EI theta C as minus 23.69 and EI delta as 12.75. Okay, you may get values little nearer or farther. Why? Because it depends upon the decimals you take. Okay, it will be but closer to this. Okay, yeah. So finally, according from our step 3, we are done with calculation of unknowns. So next comes our step number 4, which is the final moments. So how to get the final moments? Just substitute the values of EI theta B, EI theta C and EI delta in equations 1 to 6. Okay. Why? Because 1 to 6 represent the slope deflection equations. Just substitute them back there. You'll be getting all the values of final moments. MAB, MBA, MBC, MCB, MCD and MDC. You'll get these final moments. Okay. These are called final moments. Okay. Observe MBA plus MBC is equal to 0. Why? Because at joint B, we applied the equilibrium condition, right? Which was MBA plus MBC 0. So it is plus 25.38 minus 25.38. So it's balanced. Similarly, at C also, we applied the equilibrium condition, right? MCB plus MCD 0. So one is plus 28.48, one is minus 28.48. It's balanced, right? Next one is MDC, which is minus 16.62 kilonewton meter. These are called the final moments. Okay. I may proceed drawing with the bending moment diagram right now. For that, I'll calculate the bending moment in the span BC also. In the span BC means what? If you remember our question, only on BC you are having the load. AB there is no load, CD there is no load. Only on BC you are having the load, which is UDL. So the bending moment we assume to be at the center. The bending moment diagram will be a parabola. And the height of the parabola will be equal to the formula W L square by 8. So this is how I substituted 20 into 5 square by 8, which came out to be 62.5 kilonewton meter. So I'm ready with all the values to draw the bending moment diagram. I have nothing else remaining. So I can start off drawing the bending moment diagram, which will be our step number 5. So see, this is how the bending moment diagram looks. First, just draw the frame first and take the sign convention. This I am repeatedly telling you. So if you have your member like this, if your moment when you are when you are considering the moment from left to right, like for example if you are doing MBC, okay, so MBC will be from left to right, obviously MCB will be from right to left. So when you are doing for MBC, if you get negative, you should draw the bending moment above the line. Okay. And similarly, if you are doing MCB, when you get MCB positive, you should draw above the line. Are you clear? Say again, if you get MBC, MBC means from left to right, correct? If you get MBC positive, you should draw below the line. Similarly, MCB, if you get negative, you should draw below the line. So remember this sign convention. Now, according to the sign convention, I'll start drawing the bending moment diagram. Let me take the first value, MAB. MAB was 8.44 kilonewton meter. Okay. Now, come back to this sign convention. 8.44, you have to remember the value. Now, it's a column, right? So, just now, try to tilt your paper. Now, just assume this to be like a beam. What I told you, when you are moving from left to right, if you get negative value, draw above the line. But if you get positive value, you should draw below the line. Now, what I got MAB? MAB means I am moving from left to right, obviously. What I got MAB? 8.44, which is plus. So, where should I draw now? I should draw below this line. So, 8.44. Next, what did I get MBA as? 25.38. Plus 25.38. So, B to A, I am moving, which means right side, right to left. If I get positive, I should draw upwards only, according to this sign convention. If I get positive, I should draw upwards. So, I have drawn 25.38 upwards. Clear? Now, just join them. Let's go for MBC now. MBC minus 25.38. According to the sign convention, if you get BC negative, you should draw upwards. So, I have drawn 25.38 upwards. Next, MCB 28.48 positive. According to the sign convention, CB positive upward. So, 28.48 I have drawn upward. Just join both of them. You'll get a trapezium. Clear? In the similar fashion, solve for draw for MCD and MDC. MCD I got minus. Same. You can turn the paper like this itself and you can start drawing for CD also. CD means right to left. If you get positive, draw upwards. If you get negative, draw downwards. What did I get MCD as? I got negative. So, I should draw downwards according to this sign convention. So, I have drawn 28.48 down. And similarly, MDC, I got minus 16.62. Again, according to this sign convention, I got D to C negative. So, I should draw upwards. So, I have drawn upwards and I have joined. So, like this, you have to draw the bending moment diagram. Okay. It seems to be little bit confused, but you have to practice. Without practice, you can't draw the bending moment as fast as me. Okay, remember the sign convention in your mind. Practice the bending moment diagram. And as we have calculated bending moment in the span BC, it's a UDL. You get a parabola with the height of the parabola 62.5. I have drawn the 62.5. That's all. This is the bending moment diagram in kilonewton meter. And here I have a very important point to tell you. Especially when we are doing frames, whether it may be sway or non-sway, generally we don't prefer shear force diagram much. Okay, in your exam point of view also, only bending moment diagram will be asked. So be perfect at least up to bending moment diagram. If in case they ask shear force diagram, especially if they give you in the question itself, draw SFD also, then only you start drawing SFD. Okay, if it is not specified in the exam, please don't start drawing, don't get confused and don't make a mistake. Okay, so if unless until specified in the question to draw shear force diagram, then only start the shear force diagram, or else you can end up the problem with bending moment diagram. Sometimes in the question, they may not ask you draw the bending moment diagram also. They'll just say analyze the portal frame shown in the figure and they will give you the diagram. You have to check whether it is sway or non-sway, and you have to start analyzing, and you have to stop near the bending moment. Okay, if they say just analyze, it means you have to stop up to bending moment. They say draw bending moment, stop up to bending moment. But for your extra, I'm telling you shear force also. Okay, now the last step will be shear force diagram, but to draw shear force diagram we require the reactions. Correct? Just a minute. Yeah. We require compulsory reactions. Then only you can start drawing the shear force diagram. So, I don't know the values of RB, RC and also HA, HD. HA, HD, I got the formulas, that's all. But I didn't substitute the values of MAB, MBC, MDC and I didn't get the values of HA and HD that I will calculate now. Before going to that, to draw the shear force diagram, you can just consider a free body diagram of each span of the frame. So, I have drawn the FBDs of each span. So, this is the FBD of BC, this is the FBD of AB, and this is the FBD of CD. Okay. with all the moments I have shown you, clock moment, anti-clock, anti-clock, I mean how the values came from our step number 4, I have just shown all the values. Now I'll consider span BC. So RB plus RC is equal to total downward load, which is 20 into 5, 100, taking moments about B, minus RC into 5, plus 20 into 5 into 5 by 2, since it's a UDL, we consider it to be a rectangle, plus 28.48, which is in clock, minus 25.38, which is anti-clock. So just substitute and simplify, you get RC as 50.62, so RB will be 100 minus 50.62, 49.38. Similarly, your RA and RD also will carry the same values. Why? Because your RA and RB are on the same line. Similarly, RD and your RC also. But we generally don't require this. Why? Because we are already having HA and HD. As I've told you, HA, we got the formula right when we applied the equilibrium condition. MAB plus MBA by 3. Substitute the values of MAB, MBA. I got 11.27. Similarly, HD also, we got the formula right. MCD plus MDC by 4. Substitute the values, I got minus 11.27. You remember the condition, what was our equilibrium condition? HA plus HD equal to 0, plus 11.27 minus 11.27 equal to 0, correct? So, our problem is correct. Whatever we analyzed is exactly correct. It's balanced. HD, I got minus 11.27. What does this mean? It means that, how did I consider HD direction? I considered HD to act from right to left. Okay? But I got negative if I assume like this. What does this mean? HD is also acting in the same fashion as HA. HD is also acting from left to right. So that's what here it is written. Negative sign indicates that direction of HD is from left to right. And this check I have already told you. Now let's see the shear force diagram. Yeah, this is our shear force diagram. First just draw the frame. So this black color pen, whatever I have drawn, this is your shear force. I don't want to waste much time on using different colors of pens and different colors of sketches. I just want my video to be more productive. Okay, skip. I see some people using one color for a box, one color for sign convention, one color for shear force, one color. I just don't want to avoid this. I feel if you are able to concentrate, then it will be automatically useful and it will be automatically productive. So I just want to skip all those. But in order to show you exactly where is the shear force, where is the bending moment, I have just preferred a blue pen which is available with me right now. Okay, so I'll follow the sign convention, left side upward positive. If I consider a section, left side upward reactions, I'll take it as positive sign convention, right side upward acting which is onto the section, right side of the section will be taken as negative. RUN and LUP, most of the people follow the same sign convention. Okay, let's start now. If you consider BC, RB was 49.38, RB is acting upwards, which is onto the left of the section, so it is drawn upwards. LUP, RC was 50.62, correct? So right side upward will be considered as negative, correct? So this is the shear force, you have to join like this. Next, coming to here, I have HA value which is acting from left to right. So if I assume, if I turn my paper like this, now AB is looking like a beam, HA is acting like this downwards. So when left side upward is positive, left side downward will be negative. So negative shear force 11.27. Similarly, CD, I got HD, if I put HD like this, I got minus 11.27. So what did we conclude? HD is also acting in the same fashion like HA. So again, left side downward negative. So like this, you will get the shear force. Same values of 11.27 and 11.27. So this is the shear force diagram. Just for your clarity purpose. But unless until last, you need not draw the shear force diagram. Okay. So this is about sway frames. Still, once again, go through the video. I feel now it is easier. But the only thing what I want to tell you is, it's not only about frames. In structure analysis, whatever problem you are solving, whatever method you are preferring, you need to practice a lot. Okay, just not even by listening the video also, you may not get the confidence. Simultaneously, you have to keep solving the problems. Then only you can gain confidence. Then only you can have a confidence in picking up the sign conventions, confidence in drawing the diagram. It's a parabola or how anti-clock moment, clock moment. These all you'll have a perfect idea when you solve more number of problems. I generally tell to my students, if you have this problem, correct? This today's problem. What I'll tell you is just change the dimensions of your frame. Just change the type of the loading, or else just change the moment of inertia, like this. For the same frame, you can prepare some 5 to 6 models of questions. In the place of UDL, put a point load, or else with the same UDL, change the intensity of the loading. Here I took the moment of inertia 1.5. Take some other moment of inertia. Or else you can practice the same model with same moment of inertia I. Change the spans. Change this span. Like this you can practice to gain confidence. Okay? So that's all is about today's session. And thank you.